Bonsoir à toutes, bonsoir à tous, bienvenue avec le Doc. On n'est pas le week-end, on est vendredi soir et avec nous ce soir un très très grand monsieur. Il est en direct de Los Angeles, on ne l'a pas réveillé mais presque. Est avec nous ce soir en direct Stan Bush, voilà, qui vient de nous rejoindre. Je le vois en direct, so maybe Stan, can you hear me?
Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, so I would like to say thank you Stan for your times. So it's a D-Day today, so congratulations first for the new records. So how do you feel today, Stan, with these new records? And I think you are totally happy with this new one. So thanks for joining me, and how do you feel today with these new records?
Oh, it's very exciting. Yeah, we're thrilled. The reactions for the album are real good. The reviews have been great. So it's very exciting.
Yeah.
So I just, by the way, I can't see you very well. The camera's too high. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I just translate for the French people who is live today in Paris, France. So it's 7 p.m. in Paris. So 10 a.m. in Los Angeles.
Well, good evening then.
écoutez, il est très content des premières réactions qu'il y a eu. Il est très content de sortir ce nouveau disque. Et puis moi, je suis très content de l'avoir en direct parce que Stan Bush est quand même un très très grand artiste, un très très grand monsieur de la scène AOR et Melodic Rock. Donc on va continuer en posant quelques questions. Et puis si vous avez d'autres questions, n'hésitez pas à nous les poser. Je les poserai directement à Stan. Stan, first question. With your first track, we get right to the heart of the matters, I think. Great synth intro, your voice and a great guitar solo. So tell us, how did you build this track?
Oh, the Born to Fight track, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah.
Born to Fight.
Yeah, that's a new song that we wrote for the Netflix anime shows. For Netflix, they contacted me for us to write the song for the to promote the two shows, Baki and Kengan Ashura. Anyway, we wrote the song, and Netflix, they loved the song, and so we did the music video.
Yes.
And it's pretty cool.
Yes. Écoutez, oui, on a commencé tout de suite à parler de Born to Fight, hein, parce que c'est le morceau qu'il a préparé donc pour deux scènes animées de Netflix, hein, le Baki et le Kengan Ashura. Voilà, il a fait le titre, et puis Netflix a trouvé ça super, et donc derrière, il est super content parce que ça part fort. On écoutera d'ailleurs les deux titres après Born to Fight and Dare to Dream juste après l'interview. Another songs with totally crazy, I think, Stan, with the tracks the 80s, you really feel like we are back in 1980. How is it? How did you write this track? Do you miss the 80s?
Yeah, that was a great time for music, I think, you know, and I think a lot of us loved the 80s music, and I think it was kind of cool how to write a song about what it was like going back in time. You know, it was fun. It was we did the music video over the summer, and
yeah, yes,
it had a Volkswagen bus, you know, for.
Yes.
It makes you go back in time, see?
Yes, it's totally a funny video, in fact. So, yeah. Oui, donc je lui posais la question parce que un des titres qu'il a écrit, le cinquième, The 80s, nous ramène carrément dans les années 80. Et puis si vous avez pu voir la vidéo, en fait, ils sont dans un van Volkswagen, et puis ils ont enregistré la chanson dans le van. Donc ça nous revient très très loin en arrière dans les années 80. Et puis comme le dit Stan, en fait, les années 80, c'était quand même du bon temps. Hein. What a good time, 80s. C'est traduit exactement dans ce morceau, qui est un morceau très péchu, qui fait du bien, et puis on a vraiment l'impression avec ce morceau d'être dedans. So I just said to the listeners that 80s songs, it's totally the 80s vibe, because it's totally what it is in 80s, in fact. So that's a particular song in this album, I think, because it's totally like like a song which come back after a lot of songs. So it's totally crazy to come back on the 80s on the middle of your songs. Why we put this on the middle of your song, in fact? Or on the middle of your CD, sorry.
Yeah, I think I love the 80s. I think that's my music style is still that kind of thing. I love the rock songs that, when the 80s they had the songs that you remember the lyric, you yes, you shout out.
Charlotte, yes, exactly. So, comme il le dit, hein, les 80s, il y a quand même un paquet de chansons, de titres qui nous ont fait crier et qui nous ont amené beaucoup, 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 beaucoup de choses. Et c'est vrai que c'est une période quand même qui nous a marqué. Hein. On parlait juste à l'instant donc du nouvel album. On va y revenir tout de suite. Stan, you written or you co-written many songs, or do you find your inspiration now?
Well, it's I guess you remember the song "The Touch" that was from
Yeah,
the Trans.
I have one question about the touch at
Okay,
the
later. So "The Touch" was kind of a inspiration for me to. I like songs like that they lift you higher, and you feel good, and you feel like you can do anything, and it makes you. May be confident and have hope, and positive feelings,
Yeah, clearly. So, comme il le dit, hein, donc il a écrit beaucoup de choses. On parlait bien sûr de The Touch. On peut pas ne pas parler de The Touch avec Stan Bush. Mais on aura une question pour Stan regardant en phase avec The Touch, parce que cette chanson, elle est quand même le reflet de toute la carrière de Stan. Et j'ai une question pour Stan juste après, à la fin, pour parler de The Touch. One of your songs on the album is Dream Big. So, what do you dream big about?
Oh well, it's there's a it's like a guy who's talking to his son that when he he's telling his son that you can dream big, you can do whatever you want, you if you you work hard and you can achieve any dream that you want. It's like that, I think, in the guy tells his son, and then when his son grows up, he says the same thing to his son. So it's like that, it's I think all of us want our kids to do well in life, So
Oui,
yeah.
donc il y a un titre qui s'appelle Dream Big. Nous à Paris, on a Dream Bigger, hein, c'est un peu la même chose. Donc c'est vraiment la chanson. Donc je lui demandais qu'est-ce qu'il voyait dans ce titre. Et donc c'est comme un père qui propose à son fils de voir les choses en très grand, d'avancer, d'aller le plus loin possible. Et donc c'est dans cette vibe-là qu'il a écrit ce morceau. One question regarding the cover of the Dare to Dreams with a magnificent cover. Who is the author of the record cover? And I have one question for the listener since 2 days. And will the record will be released on vinyl?
Oh, who did the cover
Yeah,
art?
yes, yes,
Yeah,
yes.
his name is Nello D'Alamo. He's Italian. He did the last four
Yeah.
of my album covers. He's great. And he did the album cover artwork, so, and we were really happy with it. So, but yeah, it's about you have the boy standing on the hill, and he sees, he's dreaming, so he sees a sailing ship that's going through the air, and that kind of thing. So it's kind of a imaginary cover,
Yes, it's an amazing, amazing cover, for sure. So, comme il le dit, si vous avez eu le temps d'aller regarder cette pochette, elle est magnifique. Hein, on voit un petit bonhomme avec plein de belles choses. On voit un dirigeable qui passe. On peut l'entendre. Voilà, c'est très sympa. Et the question regarding this record cover, Stan, do you think you can release this on LP, not on CD?
I don't know if the maybe if the demand is there, certainly
Yes.
I'd be open to that.
Yeah, because
Yeah,
I think
I know
it's uh, it,
some
it,
people like the vinyl,
yeah, yes. And you are on vinyl times, so that's the
Oh.
questions. So, in fact, yes, it's a wonderful one. So I think it's beautiful idea to release this one in LP, so maybe I cross my finger. So je lui ai demandé si effectivement le disque pouvait sortir en vinyle. Bah écoutez, s'il y a de la demande, si vous voulez le voir arriver un jour en format vinyle, en format LP, et bah, achetez-le, demandez-le, et puis peut-être qu'on aura la chance de pouvoir de l'avoir. Stan, once again, it's Olga Fats who's produced your record. Did you find the right formula or alchemy or chemistry with him since 2010, I think?
Oh, even before the In This Life album, he produced that one. I think that was 2007. Holger and I are best friends for years, and he's a great guitar player, and he plays keyboards and bass, and he comes up with arrangements that are really great. We have a good chemistry together. You're right. I love Holger. He's awesome.
Yeah. So je lui disais, il travaille beaucoup avec Holger Fatt, qui est son producteur, qui a encore reproduit l'album. Donc comme il le dit, c'était déjà en 2007 qu'ils travaillaient ensemble. Et puis depuis 2010, donc il produit. Et puis il y a c'est un super guitariste, super claviériste. Il amène plein de choses et ils travaillent très bien ensemble. Et c'est comme ça qu'ils arrivent à sortir plein de bonnes choses. Et cet album en particulier est un très bon album. Encore, on dit bravo à Stan. Stan, congratulations for your new LP CD because it's a wonderful one.
Thank you so much.
So I listened many times and I say this is maybe one of my favorite of Stan Bush, except the beginning of Stan Bush, because the first one is fantastic.
Thank you so much.
So we come back, of course, for the I have one question regarding your first records. Your first records was released in 1988. Wow. We are almost in 2021. Do you think you managed to share your music with us today?
Say that again. Do you think I would?
Do you think you managed to share your music with us today?
Managed to share
Now you are in 2021, a long time ago after the first release. So do you have some other songs to be shared with us again and again, like the first records or something like that?
I don't know. I think I'll just keep doing what I do, and but as far as the new album, I think I'm happy to share those songs. And people, every time I play, people want to hear The Touch and those songs too. I have to decide what to do in concert.
Why only The Touch? You have a lot of songs.
Too many songs.
Too many songs. Oui, donc je lui disais, son premier disque, il est sorti en 1987. Hein, c'est Stan Butch at the Barrage. Bien sûr, il y a tous les grands titres. Il y a notamment The Touch dont on va parler. On est en 2021, donc je lui demandais qu'est-ce qu'il pouvait encore partager avec nous, qu'est-ce qu'il pouvait encore nous amener. Et il dit encore plein de bonnes choses. Et puis, c'est vrai que depuis 1987, il a fait quand même plein de chansons. Et les gens lui demandent tout le temps The Touch en concert. Mais effectivement, il n'y a pas que The Touch, il y a beaucoup, beaucoup de chansons faites par Stan. Et c'est un très grand plaisir de l'avoir avec nous ce soir. Stan, I have the chance to see you live in 2015 in Nottingham, if you remember, in England. And then you come back in 2019 at IT Festival. Do you think it's possible to see you again in Europe? Maybe not not for this year, for sure, but maybe next year. Do you come back at some festival like IT or Wildfest or some?
I would love to come back. Yeah, I love performing in Europe. The band I used in England when we played the Nottingham show, those guys played with me also at IT Festival. So, I would love to come back and perform again in Europe.
Cross finger. Oui, comme je lui disais, donc moi j'ai eu la chance de le voir en 2015 à Nottingham, au Rockingham Festival qui n'existe plus maintenant, et puis bien sûr au IT Festival qui est en Allemagne. Donc c'était en 2019. Je lui demandais si on aurait la chance de le revoir encore en Europe, parce qu'il vient pas souvent quand même, 2015-2019, une fois tous les 4 ans. Et puis pour le coup, Stan nous dit il aimerait bien revenir. Donc j'espère qu'on aura la chance. En plus, il est distribué par un label allemand, donc maybe we have a chance to see you again in Europe, because your label is in Germany, so we have a lot of contact in Germany, so maybe we can come back in Germany in the next 2 years, maybe.
That'd be great. I would love it. Maybe
So,
I can come to Paris.
yeah. So that's a good idea too. Maybe we can discuss.
Sounds good.
Stan, we spoke with Robert Tepper not long ago, and he's still as happy to write music and release records. So, do you think we will have the chance to have more Stan Bush records?
I'm gonna keep writing and recording, and this year has been a very creative time, and I think like I say, I'm proud of the album. I think it's really good, and so far people seem to like it a lot. So, but yeah, I'm gonna keep doing it.
Oui, donc je disais, on a parlé, comme vous le savez, il n'y a pas très longtemps avec Robert Tepper, qui était en interview sur Vinyl Time dans 213 Rock. Et puis Robert était super content d'écrire encore de la musique, de venir en concert. D'ailleurs, il a fait Nottingham aussi, Robert Tepper. Et je posais la question donc à Stan s'il voulait continuer à faire de la musique et enregistrer. Il a dit oui, il veut encore enregistrer, oui, il veut encore faire plein de choses. Et oui, j'espère qu'on le verra en France et à Paris. Stan, of course, I have one question about the touch, because we couldn't live here without talking about the touch, because it's a very good song. It's a Lush song. It's a Stan Bush song. Do you still like this title so much since all this year?
Do I still like what? The...
Do you still like this title, the touch,
Oh, yeah,
so
definitely.
much since all this year? Because it's a again and again and again, you play the touch. So,
Oh, I see. Well, it's okay. I love the song. It's but you're right. I could never play a concert without doing the touch. Nobody
yeah.
would let. They said you have to play the touch.
Yeah. Or maybe the next set list is only 11 the touch and one song for the last album. Maybe no.
Yeah, maybe right. Yeah, I'll mix it up. I'll do some new songs too. I have to do Born to Fight.
Yeah.
So,
It's.
yeah.
Oui, comme je disais, donc on pouvait pas se quitter sans parler quand même de The Touch, hein, parce que c'est l'album, c'est le morceau de Stan Bush. Et puis effectivement, il est très content de le jouer. Il le joue tout le temps. Donc c'est voilà, c'est un titre. Et pour la première fois sur un album qu'il ressort, il n'a pas mis The Touch dans une autre version que celle d'origine. Donc voilà, c'est très très étonnant, mais pour un coup, c'est super. Stan, I would like to say thank you. Thank you very much for your times. Thank you for accepting my interview tonight in Paris and tomorrow this morning in Los Angeles. So Stan,
Thank you for
thank you
the
very
feature.
much.
I really appreciate it. It's yeah, it's great. Thank you.
So before we leave, I put two songs now on direct on Vinyl Times, Born to Fight and Dare to Dreams, just after this interview. But before we leave, do you have a message for the audience tonight and for the listener in Paris and of course in Europe?
Well, the message is dare to dream, because you can make your life better. I think you can make the world better if we all can dream more, and reach for great things, reach for good, find the good in everybody,
Oh, yeah.
so.
So, Stan, thank you very much for your times. I appreciate. Cross finger for the new release with out today. Hope you have some good news and good vibration about this new release. And now we listen live, Born to Fight with Stan Bush. This is Dare to Dreams. Stan, thank you very much, and hope to see you soon in France. And take care.
Thank you. All the best.
All the best. Thank you so much.